When you think of the world's most fierce, numerous, and dominant meat-eating mammals, you probably think of animals like the big cats or wolves or bears. But long before any of those animals existed, there was another predator that prowled North America. And it was neither cat nor dog nor bear, but it was their distant relative. It had the tapering snout and long tail of a dog, but it walked on the soles of its feet and had a large body like a bear. Its name was Amphicyon, and it was one of the largest predatory mammals ever to walk the earth. And it was just one of a very diverse group of ancient meat eaters that ruled the northern hemisphere for over 30 million years. Some of these creatures were fox-like forest dwellers, others were fast, long-legged predators, and others still, like Amphicyon, were nearly as big as polar bears. Scientists refer to this group of extinct beasts as the Amphicyonids, but because of their strange combination of bear-like and dog-like traits, they're sometimes confusingly called the bear dogs. And even though you've never met one of these animals, the bear dogs are key to understanding the history of an important branch of the mammal family tree. Because at the height of their reign, the bear dogs played a pivotal role in outcompeting another group of early dominant predators, a group we've told you about before, which has also since gone extinct. And by getting rid of them, the bear dogs paved the way for their own relatives, the carnivores we know today. Natural history, like all history, is full of overlooked characters, figures that quietly shape the world around them. And if you ask me, the saga of the carnivores could never be complete without the forgotten story of the bear dogs. Now, most of the meat-eating mammals that you know today, like cats, dogs, and bears, are members of the same group, the order known as Carnivora. And it might sound like, to be a member of this group, you just have to eat meat, but Carnivora isn't synonymous with carnivore. Carnivora includes animals with diverse diets, not just meat-eaters. They range from the bamboo-chomping giant pandas to more omnivorous animals, like raccoons and even walruses. So a carnivore is any animal that eats other animals, but Carnivorans are a specific taxonomic group of placental mammals. And some of the earliest members of this group were the bear dogs. Bear dogs first appear in the fossil record around 40 million years ago during the Eocene epoch. They probably originated in North America and spread into Europe before the two continents slowly became separated. Because of that, fossils show that two distinct lineages of bear dogs wound up evolving in isolation for millions of years. One of the oldest known species is actually a tiny creature from North America called Davinus de Milo. It lived in the late Eocene, from Wyoming to Saskatchewan, where it survived on a diet of plants and small animals in the dense forests that covered the continent. And it, like all bear dogs, belonged to a group of mammals known as the Caniformia, the same group that includes today's bears and dogs, along with other familiar mammals like seals and skunks. Scientists think that bear dogs diverged from other caniforms early on, forming their own branch of the mammal family tree. Both bears and dogs evolved later, but today they are the bear dogs' closest living relatives. And because of that, bear dogs share a lot of similarities with both animals. For example, bear dogs tended to have longer, pointier snouts like dogs and bears do. And many bear dogs were large-bodied and walked with their feet flat on the ground like bears, but also had a long dog-like tail. Now, after the North American bear dogs became separated from the Eurasian species, the two groups found themselves on very different evolutionary paths. In North America, bear dogs diverged into two subfamilies, each of which played a big role in shaping the predator-prey dynamics of the continent. The first group appears in the fossil record about 40 million years ago in places like Texas and Wyoming. Early species of this group were well adapted for hunting in dense forests, like our friend Davinus, which was probably about the size of a swift fox or maybe as big as a coyote. But when these first bear dogs came about, there were bigger dogs on the scene, though they weren't actually dogs either. The fiercest apex predators in Eocene North America were the hyaenodonts, bigger, stronger carnivores, which we've talked about before. Hyaenodonts had big, powerful jaws filled with blade-like teeth. Plus, we can tell from their heel bones that some of them could make powerful leaps, suggesting they probably used an ambush hunting strategy, hiding in the forest undergrowth and tackling their prey with brute force. Now, those first little bear dogs might not have seemed like much of a threat to the hyaenodonts, but circumstances soon swung in their favor. As the Oligocene epoch began about 33 million years ago, North America was beginning to go through a major cooling and drying phase, and this opened up the landscape, turning forests into savannas. This new open environment spelled trouble for the specialized hunting style of the hyaenodonts. And they had another problem to deal with too, their teeth. Hyenodont teeth were all adapted for ripping and tearing flesh, great when you're only eating meat, but less so when your food of choice suddenly declines. Bear dogs, on the other hand, had more varied teeth. Their front teeth were used for tearing, but their molars had different shapes and sizes. Some could be adapted for crushing, puncturing, or holding prey, depending on what was selected for. And those differentiated teeth proved to be a key advantage for the bear dogs. Plus, by the start of the Oligocene, some bear dog species had gotten big, enough to compete with the hyenodonts for the same food, while maintaining more of this adaptability. The combination of direct competition from bear dogs and an unforgiving new environment spelled the end for the hyenodonts. By about 30 million years ago, they had vanished from North America. Soon, bear dogs were on the rise. By about 23 million years ago, several large bear dogs appeared, with long legs that gave them a more efficient stride, perfect for chasing down prey like three-toed horses and early camelids. But the North American bear dogs were about to face much stiffer competition, and from their own kind. About 18 million years ago, a new threat crossed the Bering Land Bridge. Even larger bear dogs, the ones that had evolved separately on Eurasia. And over there, the bear dog story had played out differently than it had in North America. At first, the Eurasian bear dogs struggled to thrive, in part because they also faced competition from the hyenodonts. But when those bigger carnivores started to decline, the bear dogs had their moment. They quickly spread across the continent and began to fill the niches that the hyenodonts had left empty. But rather than adapting to becoming sleek and long-legged like their American relatives, Eurasian bear dogs became heavier and more robust. They were also probably more opportunistic and adaptable, hunting or scavenging on large prey like hyenas do today. In fact, we have direct evidence of this. In 2006, researchers described a rhino jaw from Portugal that had bite marks matching the teeth of a Eurasian bear dog called Amphicyon giganteus. So, when the large bear dogs arrived in North America, it spelled trouble for the locals. And they were just one part of a whole wave of Eurasian carnivores that came over, shaking up the dynamics of whole ecosystems. These new carnivores outcompeted the North American bear dogs, and by about 17 million years ago, they were extinct. The Eurasian bear dogs, however, thrived in their new habitat. They grew even larger, reaching sizes that put them among the biggest mammalian land predators of all time. Two species of these giants were ambush predators the size of polar bears that roamed western North America. They had powerful forelimbs, massive clawed feet, and muscular jaws that could deliver a crushing bite. But these bear dogs were about to meet the same double threat as the hyenodonts that came before them: new competition and climate change. However, this time, the situation was reversed. Bear dogs had outcompeted the hyenodonts in part by being adaptable generalists, able to eat more kinds of food when conditions changed. But then those bear dogs were replaced by more specialized hunters, members of their own family, the modern carnivorans. Some of these new carnivorans included hyenas in Eurasia and borophagines in North America. You may know them as the bone-crushing dogs. Both of these animals could shatter bones with their teeth, something that bear dogs couldn't do, which made them more efficient scavengers. Plus, there was also the arrival of the cats, which began to compete for the niche of hypercarnivore, with their razor-sharp teeth and retractable claws. Meanwhile, bears, actual, real bears, had diverged and spread, with teeth that were adapted to a more omnivorous lifestyle. All of these new carnivorans were doing everything that bear dogs could do, but better and in more targeted ways. Clearly, the days of the bear dogs were numbered. The North American bear dogs had already been outcompeted by the giant Eurasian bear dogs. And with only huge ambush predators left on both continents, they couldn't stand up to the more specialized cats, dogs, and bears. Some of the last species we find in the fossil record belong to the genus of the mighty Amphicyon. By about 9 million years ago, bear dogs on both continents were gone. But we shouldn't forget the role they played in shaping predator dynamics in the age of mammals. Their rise helped the carnivorans outdo their competitors, the hyenodonts. And their fall was accompanied by the rise of the modern cats, dogs, and bears we know today. When the last of them vanished, the bear dogs had formed a kind of bridge between old and new. A missing puzzle piece in the 45-ish million year saga of the meat-eating mammals. Hey, big thanks to this month's Eontologist, Patrick Seifert, Jake Hart, John Davison Ng, and Steve. Become an Eonite by pledging your support at patreon.com/eons. And also, high fives for joining me in the Constantine Hassa studio. Be sure to subscribe at youtube.com/eons.